Hello from Chem Help ASAP. Let's see how the stereochemistry of the diene and dienophile affect the stereochemistry of the cycloadduct. Let's start with the dienophile because it's easier. To the far left, we have two dienophiles. They are disubstituted, two R groups. The top dienophile is the trans isomer. The bottom is cis. Does this matter? Yes, the stereochemistry of the dienophile affects the stereochemistry of the cycloadduct. If the trans dienophile undergoes a cycloaddition, let's number all the carbons, you will get this product with the two R groups trans. Again, let's number everything. The R groups are trans on carbons 5 and 6, the carbons that were part of the dienophile. The trans nature of the R groups in the dienophile gives trans R groups in the cycloadduct. Remember that the Diels-Alder does not have any intermediates. It's just one step, and there's no opportunity for stereochemistry to be changed during the reaction. If the cis dienophile did the cycloaddition, then the two R groups would be cis on the ring in the product. How about the diene? The stereochemistry of the diene is less obvious. When drawn in its s-cis conformation, as we have on the screen, I tend to refer to groups as being either in or out. The in groups point to the inside part of the molecule. The out groups, there's going to be a big lasso, stick out. Groups that are out will be cis to one another in the cycloadduct. Groups that are in will also be cis. In our product, the two in groups, B and C, are cis. They are both up on the ring. The two out groups, A and D, are cis. They are both down. Note that carbons 2 and 3 end up as part of the alkene and the cyclohexene. So there is no stereochemistry to discuss for any R groups on those carbons. That's how the stereochemistry of the groups on the diene and dienophile are reflected in the final product. The stereochemistry of the diene and dienophile is retained in the product because the reaction is a one-step process without intermediates.